Most people in life are looking at how do I make a life worth living and retirement happen. When a man falls in love, he literally chooses the way of the Lord, and that is to leave the house of his mother and father, go out into the world, pursue a career, and then meet a girl. When he meets that right girl, he spends a good amount of time with her, and that lifetime relationship that lasts as long as it lasts is, well, as good as it gets. But at some point he meets the real one, the one that's for him, and whether that relationships last 20 years until there's a departure or a closure, or whether that one lasts only a few weeks until it can have another chance again, that's truthful. That is what happens in the world, that we meet people that God puts on our path, and then other people screw it up for us. They give us bad advice, they interfere with our life, and they just say, that one's not for you, we don't think so. Well, you know what? It's not your right to say so. The intimate relationships between men and women are just that, between that man and that woman, or, in the cases of other type of relationships, a simple one-on-one relationship. I'm not going to get into all those fucking letters that I keep seeing blasted across controversial issues because I'm like, I don't get it. Under all the laws of the world, we have the right to choose our loving partner, no matter who or what that is, as long as the person is of the age of majority. So all this letter shit just drives me crazy, and when I saw more letters added onto that fucking thing, I just want to slap them all. You see, underneath the World Human Rights Treaty and Declaration, we have the right to choose our loving relationships. It says so quite plainly. Some of us, why the fuck we're still talking about this? In life, we have moments of time to talk about the truth, and the truth is, Americans are dumb. Now, can I say it any louder than that? You are motherfucking dumb, and if you came to this country to try to play here, stay here, and not do the right thing here, you too are brutally dumb. What I mean by that is that people are walking by me from Iranian countries and blacks, and they're literally playing my entire Twitter account in my face. I'm like, first of all, I never gave you my Twitter account. Second of all, how you got it, I don't know. But third, you don't have the right to keep monitoring my life through any type of cybercrime, identity theft, or fraud. So let's be clear. If you're an American citizen, congratulations. You were born in one of the best countries in the world. We are not the best country in the world, but we're pretty darn good. And we pretty much lead the world in a lot of ideas and a lot of concepts. But where we're dumb is not recognizing the laws that trump other laws. You see, it's great to have all these city ordinances, but if the stupid foreigners that come here do not regard our noise ordinances, then we're suffering with Indy 500 cars every day in noise. And I have noise sensitivities, so I don't like it much. I also think it's ridiculous because it can cover other sounds that we often hear on campus and we go, whoa, this is a problem. I know it's a problem because some black girl walked up to me and said that I was allegedly all around her girlfriend. I'm like, I don't even know who the fuck your girlfriend is. And she flashed a gun at me. I was sitting on a campus property. I was sitting on that property to point something out to the ownership, but instead maintenance man decided to run me off because they're too stupid about what I do for a living. And I wasn't about to tell a $10 an employee what I was there for, or the fact that I actually know the vice president of his fucking company, at least through LinkedIn, and maybe some other social media channels. We do know each other that way because in a time of COVID, it's not like I can walk in the office and have a conversation with someone because they'll just look at me and go, they'll look at my pack and go, what the fuck are you? And they won't take me the least bit seriously. Sorry, it sucks. Police took my fully paid for business vehicle. Go fuck you. And I'll be that way for the rest of my life. I had siblings who interfered with my vehicle. They literally let somebody repair a vehicle and they literally took $5,000 to do it and it ruined the car. And sheriff ruined the car after that. So don't tell me that we don't need to defund the police. We have plenty of Army reserves that can do the job if they're well-trained and if they understand the treaties of the world. They also need to know the Constitution of America. Apparently it's only a one-page document. That's what I saw when I looked at it, and I haven't seen that in a long time because I used to carry a book in my property bags. It was of the Constitution and the amendments. I was so pleased to have it. It was a gift from my father. And all that stuff has now been confiscated, stolen, and taken from me by law enforcement officers when I had that lovely chance to stay in jail for 3 months' time, locked in a tower, by myself, with only the books that I wrote for to read. Now, in life, we have moments of time to make an impact on a place. And I wrote 15-some letters on my own dime, my own paper, my own pen, ink that I paid for, and openly only one ministry that I know of in the time that I was there responded to me. It took a while to get the mailman to actually do his fucking job. The black mailman is better than the white man for sure, and I can just say that because of the kindness of his soul. I think he understood the difficulty that I was in. But to have to be suffering through 200-some fucking people to know about my medical rights, which wasn't their right, I blame on a nurse named Linda, and then some officers that just didn't do things right. But in life, my life is my life. And since I've come to this community, somebody has made my life not my life. And I guarantee it's some ill-willed police officer who's white and gay and can't stop fucking my life. Out of jealousy, out of who knows what, but it's still a sexual hate crime, it's a religious crime, what they did to my beard, and openly, it's not fun to be here. This is a stupid little back-assword town with affluent and influential children of people who have crowns, and frankly, I don't give a shit. But the point is that I'm here to protect people's lives, I'm here to protect people's attitudes about life, and if they don't fucking get their shit together in terms of what they're studying in school, they will have a life like mine, living in the streets in poverty. I didn't choose this path, but I'm peaceful at this path, and when I stay up late because I slept all day, I'm content to not have to watch all the shit that walks around the community. What I mean by that are the people that are allowed to go down and panhandle at the Circle K until they get enough cash from the customers there to come down to the McDonald's and buy themselves dinner. Sorry, but there is a shelter that you, buddy, can go to. I just prefer not to go there because of how they handle me there. I don't have to keep talking about my life. I don't have to keep squawking about my life. I don't know why God channels this shit for you, but frankly, he wants you to get it. Then my life is my life, your life is your life, and when you cross into my life, aggress against my life, cut my dick off, or do anything to impede my manhood, I'm going to fucking kill you.